After 2.5 years of war, the British were forced to negotiate, and a truce was called in July 1921. Not one woman was included in the committee to negotiate peace. The women who asked to take part were considered by De Valera to be too militant or too extremist. The treaty that was signed in 1921 gave Ireland the status of a free state. It was not the republic fought and died for in 1916. It was an extension of home rule, and members of the Dáil would have to swear an oath of allegiance to the crown. For the first time since 1900, the women's movement began to split. Those who favored the treaty became known as Cumann na Saoirse. Cumann na Mban's opposition to the treaty was overwhelming. They now became, as De Valera would later describe, the most unmanageable of revolutionaries. Civil war broke out.
People that you trusted implicitly before that, you couldn't trust them anymore. It was an awful time, really. Ever after that, you were never safe. I used to be sent in dispatches to different places. One time I was sent with a rifle. When I got down to Fleet Street, I saw them, people hiding in doorways, and I hid in the doorway, and they were firing at one another from one end of the street to the other. So I was wondering what would happen if I was caught with my rifle. But you didn't mind being arrested or what had happened during those days. You did it all for Ireland.
I was in jail some of the time, but there was a period when I was a driver for the IRA. I brought communications up to the northern border. I brought communications also down to the 2nd Southern Division in Rose Green, County Tipperary. And going into Rose Green in the night, one had to turn up the car's lights and blow the horn, because otherwise you'd get shot.
I remember I got up to the top floor, to a cell in the top floor, and it was marked out, I suppose, by some one of the main prisoners before the forecourts. And that was my cell. And Mary McSweeney and Mrs. Humphreys and Sheila Humphreys, they were moved and us too. So we were all in Kilmainham. And it was a dreary place.
Mary McSweeney, a sister of Terence, who had died on hunger strike, was the first woman to resort to a hunger strike in the Civil War. When her sister Annie was refused permission to see her, she camped at the gates of the prison and went on her own hunger strike. At the end of April 1923, the governor of Kilmainham decided to remove some of the women prisoners to a workhouse called the North Dublin Union. The conditions in Kilmainham were so poor, the women would have welcomed the move, but for their concern for the health of two of the hunger strikers, Mary McSweeney and Kate O'Callaghan. On the evening of April the 13th, military police began to forcibly remove women from the prison. It would take them 5 hours.
After I'd been dragged from the railings, a great hand closed over my face, blinding and stifling me, and thrust me back down to the ground among trampling feet. I heard someone who saw scream, and I wondered how Miss McSweeney could bear the noise. After that, I remember being carried by one or two men and flung down into the surgery to be searched.
Dear Bridie, my jail experience is written in fire across my brain, never to be effaced. Yours truly, Polly, North Dublin Union, 1923.
Bridie Halpin did try to efface the memory of prison at the end of the Civil War. Like many of the women who emerged from prison, she chose emigration.